Hello everyone, I'm JazzJack and I would like to show you a tutorial on creating panels on curved surfaces. The subject was recently covered by Dan Brown on the Suji Cookie site, although my method is a little bit different and I would like to show it to you. So I am recreating the shape that Dan created for the sake of his tutorial, and I think it will be a good demonstration to use the same subject. So, first of all, we're going to use a mirror modifier and then a add split modifier. Without option, we're going to shape the thing smooth and rotate it more conveniently on the x-axis. Okay, so now I'm creating the edge loop right here, and this is where my method is different from Dan's, because I am using the insert tool. For the first insert, I will use the zero depth option and let's say 0.2 for the thickness, and I'm going to do the same thing with the different areas of the mesh where I want to create the panel. Alright, so that's the step one. Now step two would be selecting those inner parts once again to create the panel itself. And I'm going to use the insert tool once more for the sake of it. And this time I'm going to go 0.03 for the depth. Now, difference between me and Dan is going to be that I actually leave a little bit of a slope of the wide angle between the surface of an insert and surface of the side of the panel, because I find it more convenient to make the normal maps and all that stuff later on. So you can actually recreate Dan's method by going zero on this parameter. Anyway, I'm gonna go with my setting right here. Okay, so now we have our panels, and you can already see that it differs from Dan model because it has this crease in the middle of it. We can quickly fix it by deleting those faces right here on the side and moving the whole edge to the Y, and boom, there we go. I believe that Dan model has also panel right here, which I'm going to recreate quickly, and once again, and froze, and it's going to go 0.03 right here to create a panel, and the same thing goes for the faces on the side here. We can delete them and move the whole thing on the y-axis. So, there it is. It works quite good, although I usually don't use the automatic angle split. I tend to use the sharp edges only because it gives me the full control over the which edges are going to be split. Now, one more thing that Dan did in his tutorial is he used a bevel to smooth out the edges of the panels. What I would do is that I would go with just a bevel tool manually, which is destructive for the mesh, but it gives you, again, more control. So you could do it like this, for example. Alright, you can see the outcome here, nice smooth edge, or even you could do it with this one. Come on, come to me. Okay, there you go, right? Very nice smooth edge. You could also do it with a modifier, although it is troublesome at this point. I'm going to show you why. I couldn't figure out how can you create a good bevel that would work nicely with the shading. Because you see, you get a lot of errors. It doesn't look good at all. Although, the one way around it is to use the bevel weights, which you can find right here on the top. And I'm going to show you how this thing works. works. Let's say we're going to use it on this panel. No, we're going to use it on the outside lines of this panel. Okay. Let's change it to 1. And I would actually have to do it with those two edges right here. Also, okay, so as you can see, it's starting to look much, much better. If we use it properly on all the edges we need to, it will look quite good. Now, there's still an issue with the bottom part of the mesh, so you would actually have to go and mark it sharp this time and use the edge modifier without a selection by the edge, okay? And it's starting to come out really nice. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed it. See you next time.